What's freshman year actually like? Show. Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. For those who are new here, my name is Julie, nice to meet you. And today I'm going to be doing a little college Q&A slash advice type of situation. For those of you who didn't watch my last video, I'm doing a little back to school series and especially like focusing on college. Today I am going to be doing like a little college Q&A slash advice thing like I said before. So I asked you guys questions on Instagram, which if you guys want to participate in my next Q&A type of video type of thing, make sure to go follow me on Instagram because whenever I do one of those, I always put on my story and ask you guys to ask me questions. But I also found some of these questions online. Some of them are like generic questions and some of them are like spilling the tea about college. So that's what I'm trying to do here. I feel like no one really gives like, I don't want to say no one because I haven't seen every single college video, but I feel like sometimes it's a little bit sugar-coated, which I'm not gonna like go like super duper into detail. Just I wish things people would have told me or questions I would have asked before I went to college. So whatever, you'll see. So the first couple questions are going to be school related, things related to classes and all that. I feel like people only ask like how do you get into college and all that, not so much of like once you get to class, like how it really is. Okay, so let's just start off with the basics. What college do I go to? I go to Florida State University. It's located in Tallahassee, Florida. No one has a country accent. I just do that whenever I say Tallahassee, Florida for some reason. Why did you choose your college and are you happy there? So I chose my college because I wanted to go away. I decided that pretty soon on. I was actually stuck between two schools. I was stuck between FSU and Auburn. I happened to get into both, which was good and bad because then I had to make a decision. But honestly, FSU just seemed like the right decision. And I am really happy that I went there. I don't think I would have had the same experience at Auburn as I did at FSU. Not saying Auburn's bad. I would have just had a different experience, but I'm really happy that the experience that I've had so far. How much time do you spend studying? I'm gonna be honest, I'm not a big studier. Studying, like, I can't just sit there and like focus. I know people that study for like days upon days upon days. I'm more of a study the night or two before, do Quizlets and all that, something that I can just quickly retain the information. And then also my major isn't like a bunch of studying. I'm an entrepreneurship major. It's more like interactive in a way. So thankfully, like, we don't have that much. We still need to study because there are some things that like you learn, you gotta take a test. I would say if I had to do it like in a week, on average like 1 to 2 days a week, I think. I feel like that's pretty good considering. I would say freshman year I study a little bit more because my classes were more studying wise, but since my classes are a little bit more interactive this time and like I have more group projects and all that, it's not as much studying. Do a lot of students join Greek life or and are you a part of it? I was actually gonna rush my freshman year. Going into my freshman year, my friend Lauren and I, we were gonna rush together, but then the application the date just kept on getting pushed and then we just kind of forgot about it. And then I was actually thinking about it during my sophomore year as well because I didn't want to rush in spring because I wanted to like not just be there for a semester, I wanted to do like the whole thing. When sophomore year came around, I'm like, is the money like really worth it? I've already have friends, made friends, who knows, maybe I could have made new friends, but I didn't see it worth it for me. And sometimes I'm like, oh, do I wish I joined a sorority? But then I'm like, I feel like the money that I would have spent doing the sorority, I could just put so much better things in my opinion. And oh, in terms of is everyone a part of it, there are a lot of people a part of it honestly, but I wouldn't say it's like the majority of everyone. I know also a lot of people that drop from their sororities, different reasons, whether it's financial or a little bit of fakeness and all that. Do with that what you will. I wouldn't say if you go to FSU you need to join a sorority or Greek life. If you want to, go ahead. To each their own. How do you get around to campus? So my old apartment, it was really really off campus, so I had to take a bus and then walk because I had a car, but parking on campus is a I tried a couple times. You have to go like at certain times to get parking because that's when people are leaving class or whatever, but you're never like guaranteed a spot. The times I did drive to class, I got a lot of like anxiety and I would make it on time most of the time, but I personally didn't like driving. There was a bus stop right next to my apartment. It was like an FSU bus system, so it wasn't honestly that bad. I enjoyed my walk to the bus and looking out the window. It wasn't horrible. I'm not like a super like complaining or picky person when it comes to those types of things. If I gotta get there a certain way, I gotta get there a certain way. And then I just walk to class. But now this year I'm living so much closer to class, which again, like I said, I didn't mind taking the bus. There it had its faults like timing wise and all that. So I am excited to walk to class now, but most people walk to class. Some people drive. How are the dorms really? So I lived in a dorm my freshman year. I really enjoyed the dorms. I wasn't that scared because I at FSU, there's no communal communal bathrooms. I know there was one in one dorm, but I think that dorm shut down. My dorm was like pretty like okay, like it wasn't like 5-star top tier. There was other dorms that were new, like newer builds that were a little bit nicer. But I enjoyed dorm life. I would not do it again. I think I enjoyed it because my friends and I were like pretty much in the same dorm. Dorm life isn't that bad. You get a meal plan or you can do grocery shopping yourself. There's kitchens. If I had to live in a dorm again, like I wouldn't completely mind because it's not that big of a deal, but I wouldn't choose to. How big are the classes? So it depends on what classes you take and your major. Freshman year, a little bit of sophomore year, my classes were bigger. I've been in classes of like 1,000 people to a class of like 20. So it really depends. So I don't know what they're called, but like the required classes in order to graduate, I guess that's what they're called, you have to take. I had people in my class that were seniors and I'm like, why don't you just do this your freshman year? Because they like put it off.
Okay, so I'm editing this now and I was confused a little bit editing this, so I'm sure you guys are too. So pretty much what I'm saying here is that the classes that are required by like, at least for like the state of Florida that like you have to take. So there's like XY credits, which are like the cultural credits. There's like, you have to take like 2 science credits, actual things besides your major classes that everyone needs to take in order to graduate. And a lot of those, if you take like APs and stuff in high school, it gets rid of them. But I'm talking about here, like the actual like big requirement classes, like the, I think it's like 2 math classes, like 2 science classes, like those types of classes, not necessarily those major classes that basic like general requirements, that's what it's called. General requirements, most people take them their freshman or sophomore year because it's just easier to get them out of the way and you can focus more on your major. That is what I'm talking about. Okay, back to the video.
More of like the main classes that everyone takes are bigger, but at least for my major, my classes are smaller. More your freshman year and like maybe a little bit of your sophomore year, you'll have like really big classes, but as time goes on, your classes will get smaller depending on your major. Are the professors chill? Some yes, some no. I haven't had like a super duper duper like strict professor. My professors are pretty chill. You know how they're like, oh, the professors are like super strict, or they're like, oh, a professor will decide there's like get there in like 10 minutes and he's like, you guys can go home. It's not like that. Sometimes like classes do end early. I would say most like teachers are like pretty chill, but like you still have to do work, you know. Are college tours important? I believe so, yes. My freshman and sophomore year of high school, I did not want to go away. I wanted to go to FIU, which was like right here. I did not want to leave home. I was like, I'm staying here, I don't want to leave. And then my junior year, I went to tour at GCU, which is Florida Gulf Coast University. My parents were like, just take a tour and see how it is. So I took a tour and I was like, oh no, I'm leaving. So it did change my mind of like wanting to leave. And then going into my senior year, we did a college road trip like all throughout Florida. We visited UF, FSU, Auburn, University of Alabama, and LSU. I think those are the 5 we visited. But I think taking the tours really changed my mind. I was not an FSU person whatsoever. I grew up a UM family. I was like, I'm never gonna go to FSU. But then as soon as I toured it, I fell in love with it. So I feel like it's really important if you have the opportunity to go visit a college, and especially like try to do it before you apply. Just go and like sense like the vibe, you kind of see, and then when you get there, like don't be afraid to ask questions. I had my mom to do that for me because she just asked a million and one questions. Okay, I think that was it with school related. So now we're gonna get into like more of like the social aspect. So I'm not gonna talk about like going out that much because I wanna do like a whole video just talking about that, answering going out questions in college. Like I wanna, like a whole separate thing because I feel like that just, it's a topic on its own that no one really talks about. Stay tuned for that. And if you have questions for that, just leave them down below. How do you make friends / did you come into college with friends? I'm gonna answer did I come to college with friends first? Yes and no. I went to summer first, wanted to kind of get to know the campus a little bit more, kind of meet people on my own. I'm the only person from my friends that did summer, so I pretty much went by myself. Going into summer C, I didn't know anyone. There was a couple girls from my high school, but like I wasn't like super close to them, and I met friends. And then when fall came, a ton of my friends came to FSU, so I was able to like introduce some people. So when it says how to make friends, I didn't find it like super difficult to make friends. I feel like I'm pretty good like adapting to change. So my roommate, like we had these 2 soulmates, and one of them introduced me to one of her friends from high school that they had kind of known each other. I became really close to that girl. This sounds complicated, but pretty much like you meet people through people. Don't like try to be shy. You meet a ton of people at college. Do they all become your friends? No. Do they become friendly? Yes. Try to be open to new people. Like don't try to make pre-judgments about people. Just be open. Just be nice to everyone. anyone, and then you'll see like who you click with, who you don't click with. So what is the difference between high school and college? Which one do you like better? I like college better, like 1000%. Like high school, obviously you're living at home. In college, you just have more freedom. I feel like more people in college are real. See, because in high school, I feel like you're trapped with the same people for 4 years, and then college, there's so much more people from so many different other places. At least Miami, like, it's kind of like a bubble. So when you go to college, you like, if you make the effort, you can kind of get out of that bubble. Yeah, college is more independent, more freedom. Like when I come back home, I'm always like, mom, can I do this? And my mom's like, you're 21, you can do whatever you want. College, like, I also feel like people are a little bit more friendly and open. Like just people, especially your freshman year, people are just trying to make friends. What's freshman year actually like? Show. That's what freshman year is actually like. Everyone has different experiences, obviously. Some people go insanely, insanely crazy, and some people don't. It just depends on like what you're into. But I felt like freshman year, I just needed to get certain things out of my system. And also, I feel like freshman year is a time to kind of gain new experiences. I'm not talking about like drinking or anything. It's like the 1 year that it's okay to make huge mistakes. Like you're getting your new sense of freedom, and you learn so many like life lessons, and you make mistakes and all that. Like for me, I'm happy I had the freshman year that I did. I had some L's, I had some W's. Like sophomore year, I was mature in freshman year, but I feel like I really, really matured going into the next year, because I'm like, I don't want to make the same mistakes I did last time, so let's kind of change it up. And I felt like it helped me kind of like mature a little bit more in different ways. So everyone has different experiences, but all in all, freshman year is just an awkward time. You're trying to like find more friends, you're trying to like figure out what type of crowd or like what you want. So it's pretty much a shit show. That's what I'm trying to say. Okay. What do you do when you're not in class and weekends? Mostly just chill. This year, my goal is, even though like we're stuck in the thing, I'm only planning on seeing like the same like 10 people throughout the semester or whatever. When I'm not in class, I usually just chill, whether it's by myself or I'm hanging out with people, I'm filming or editing and stuff like that, eating. Last semester in college, I work out. I work out with my new roommates, my workout buddy. Then at night, go out or go out to happy hour, depending on the day of the week or how I'm feeling. What's the drinking culture? Again, I'm not gonna get super into this because I wanna make this like a whole video. The drinking culture is there. It's there, but honestly, if you don't wanna do it, you don't have to do it. I know people that didn't drink so they were 21, which we do not condone underage drinking. You don't have to drink if you don't want to. It's a large aspect of like the socialness, whether it's like happy hour or going out. Again, you don't have to do anything you don't want to. You can just go and chill and not drink. Do you get homesick a lot? No. I'm not the type of person to get homesick at all. Like, I know people that do get really badly homesick when they're gone for long increments of time. I never have this desire to be like in the middle of the semester, oh, I need to go home for a weekend. That's just me. How is dating in college? I feel like now there's a new age of dating. There's online like dating. I personally don't do that. It's just like not my thing right now. Maybe, who knows, maybe in the future I will, but like I don't think it's me. I'm more the type of person that I'd rather meet someone face to face. My advice is, I feel like when you're actively looking for it or really looking for it, it's not gonna come to you. And then when you're not looking for it, it's gonna happen. I feel like meeting people at the bars is like the easiest way to meet someone. It's different for everyone, but whatever path you decide to go on, whether it's online dating or just meeting someone, put yourself out there. So to end off this video, I'll just give some advice. One, don't go somewhere because your friends are going or your family wants you to go. Go somewhere where it's gonna be best for you, because if you're miserable in college, it's just gonna be like a horrible experience, and it's so, so much money that it's not worth having a bad experience just because you went somewhere that your friends want to go. Go to college tours, just go see what you vibe with. If you don't like somewhere, like speak up, because it's better to like not waste the money and just like transfer somewhere else that you're actually gonna enjoy. And just because you transfer in doesn't mean you're not gonna make friends. Don't be scared to put yourself out there, whether it's dating wise or like making friends wise. Talk to everyone when you're out, if you having a conversation with someone in the bathroom, honestly, in the clubs, and like at the bars, you meet such nice people. Talk to everyone. You never know like which like friendships or relationships are gonna like stick. Don't be scared to make mistakes. It all happens. Even like, I know I said like most of your mistakes get like done freshman year, you still make mistakes as time goes on. Just don't be like, try to be too hard on yourself. College is like, especially the transition from high school to college is very weird, and you're gonna like find new things about yourself or find new interests that you have or you don't have. Don't be scared to make those. All together, ba-boom, wisdom, knowledge. much. That is going to be it. Like I said at the beginning, this is a back to school call like series. So let me know what you guys want to see from there. I just did a video on like actual things that you need in college, not just like the basic list that everyone gives you. So that'll be somewhere linked down below or here, so you guys can go check it out. If you guys have any suggestions, not even like after this whole back to school thing is over, I'd still like to make videos about college. I have some experience in college, so just let me know down below, or again, like I said, the going out thing, questions or advice that you guys want for going out in college. Also, before I end this, I would like to say I'm going to be posting Mondays and Thursdays now. With school coming back, it is a little overwhelming to only have one day in between, to have a break in between the shoot and whatever, and with schoolwork and everything. And this is also my last year and I want to enjoy it, so I don't want to feel like overwhelmed or pressured. So I moved it to Thursday to give myself a little bit more leeway time. So wanted to put that out there. So thank you guys for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe, turn on the post notifications. I post every Monday and Thursday, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.